What's going on, everybody? I'm Michael, your RV guy here at the Great Outdoors RV in Greeley, Colorado. Today, we got a special unit review, Wildwood Platinum 22RBS. We are gonna be 26 feet, 11 inches tip to tail, and 6,100 pounds. Let's look right at the front here. Electric tongue jack, literally just an up and down with a touch of a button, and they do have a nice light here you can turn on at night too. Two 20-pound tanks with the tank cover, that is nice to have. We do have room for two batteries here at the Great Outdoors. We are gonna provide you with one to start off with. And then you also have a nice battery disconnect location there too, so that's easy to shut it off and on. Let's go right down the side of the camper now. We do have ours in the fiberglass edition, so that's gonna be a little bit lighter weight, so that's nice for you guys. And then looking right at the front, huge pass-through storage, tons of room in there. There is a light if we were just to have turned it on. And then you got a little laundry chute here too. So it's nice, you got plenty of room. They do finish the floors in there. And I always love this, they provide you with a whiteboard. So if you're like me and forget stuff, you can make your notes right there. Nice and easy, they have a nice lock here too, you can lock it right up. Looking down the side, a couple windows going right here. We got one in the bedroom, one in the main living, one off your entry door here. Two outside speakers, convenient water heater location. And then check this out. We do have the electric stabilizers on this one too. So it's literally just an up and down button. We do have an electric awning. It does here, I've never really mentioned this in a video, but these do adjust. So if you come on this side, Nick, there's actually a little label here that tells you you can actually adjust the pitch on this. So that's nice to know, especially in the windier days. LED light bar going across your awning. This is a 16-foot awning too, so you can fit a picnic table underneath this too. Like I said, two outside speakers. 30-inch entry door. So we're gonna have a wider entry door on this one with a screen room. And you know what's funny is they started putting these in the Forest River products a couple years ago. A lot of people get rid of them. They're great for the dog. So if you have a dog that you don't want running right through that screen door, you can always keep that and it'll make your life a little bit easier. But that's nice. Nice screen door. Solid steps, so you don't have to worry about, you know, the fold-out steps getting creaky on you. Handle here too, so nice good grab handle you could walk up the stairs with. This is a couple's coach, so you know, you're picturing anybody using this camper. We want to make sure everybody's safe and comfortable getting up the stairs. On the back of the camper, we do have a prep for a backup camera. Lippert's new ladder system, so it doesn't have a ladder on the camper already, but you can get one right through lippert.com or our parts store, and this ladder actually accordions all the way to the ground. So instead of you having to do aerobics and climb up the camper, literally comes right to the ground, so that's gonna be a lot safer for you. Bumper on the back here, so you can put a cargo rack if you'd like to. The camper will come with a spare tire. On the back side of the camper, we got a couple of your water connections. All your sewer locations are all right down there. Two tires here. Dual axle is what I was really trying to say. And this camper is prepped for a slide topper, so that's nice to know too. Let's go along on the inside here now. I'll let Nick go in first. But as you walk in there, you're gonna see that you have a nice L-shaped couch, and that couch will fold out to a bed, and it does come with a nice table that you can actually clip on in there. Oh, here comes my dog stopper there. Right as you come in here too, check this out. Huge pantry space. The light does come on and off automatically, so that's pretty nice. But like I said before, this turns into a bed. It's this easy. You should just grab right here, bang. Nice size bed. I was literally just laying down in that while I was waiting for Nick, and I was completely comfortable. So put it back together, just pinch it together. And I don't know if you noticed, but when I lifted that up, you can kind of see underneath here. So you get a whole bunch of plastic bins this camper comes with. You get an additional, with those bins there, you got 20 cubic feet of storage just in those bins alone. And they all have a nice easy spot to go into right underneath your couch here. This is the location for where your table goes. You could store that behind the couch. That's a nice easy spot to put it. Literally just slips right in there and you got a nice table to sit, you know, two or three people right here. Looking in the back of the camper, like I said, this is the 22RBS, so this is gonna be a rear bath addition. This is massive. You got a ton of cabinet space here. You can even hang stuff up. You can put shelves in there if you'd like to, but there's a ton of room right there. It's absolutely ridiculous. Underneath the sink, you even got some more storage there. Big sink, enough to fit your face in. Not shy on the storage on the medicine cabinet. Nice window back here. You don't really get a window in a bathroom nowadays, so that's nice to have. And you even got more linen closets right there too. So it's plenty of space. They took this whole idea here right out of the marine industry. So that's just a magnet. Works really good. It's very strong. It has a magnet on both sides, so you can keep it open or keep it closed. Shower is huge. I'm 5'7". I got quite a bit of extra room above my head there. So if you're a taller person, this is going to be pretty comfortable for you. But overall, just having the toilet being in this position here, this whole room is set up right. It's very comfortable in the back here. Looking at your entertainment section, room for a huge TV right here. Nice spot for your, you know, boxes or whatever you end up bringing. Wires can all get jabbed right up through there. And there is another hole right here so you can throw your wires right through it so you don't have to drill them yourself. Control panel where it controls your slide, your awning, your lights, your water heaters. And this is where you can read your levels for your tank and battery. Sound bar, this is all going to be connected to the zone 1 and 2. So you got zone 1 in here with your two speakers inside here. And then you got some outside too. But you can select which one you want to be playing off of. And you can even select two different ones at the same time and have music outside, movie inside, whatever you want to do. So that's really nice. Electric fireplace, that is going to put off about 10 to 15 degrees of heat depending on the temperature. So that's nice to know. Coming down the kitchen here. Three burner cooktop with a nice cover. Oven, big enough to fit your cereal boxes. Microwave, plenty of room to cook, but you're going to do most of your cooking outside in a camper anyway. AC central located right in the main living here. Check out this. So they don't do any impediment through this. So you could actually put things all the way through. You can get things from any cabinet. Of course, if it's over here, you can't open that one. But it's nice to have no impedance in the cabinetry there. Nice glass inlays too. That looks good. Solid countertops here. They're not the solid surface ones, but they're the pressed board. They are, but they do work really well. This is great for camping. You don't got to worry about these getting dirty. They're easy to clean, and you got plenty of cabinet space here too. More cabinets underneath. They even put some drawers in here for you. Nice and fancy. So this is a 23. So they did a couple new things, like the fiberglass on the outside. I told you I'll talk about that a little bit more. This is your king bed in a couple's coach. So this is, like I said, 26 feet, 11 inches tip to tail, and they're giving you a king bed. So this is massive, but you see how they had to cut it a little bit on the edge here, so that way you could still get around pretty easily. You know, you would think if you had a king bed in here, you really couldn't get anywhere, but they gave you plenty of room. And then this is nice too. Piston-assisted lift on the bed goes all the way to the ceiling. Now I got a whole bunch of room. I can start doing cartwheels in here, you know? This is what I'm talking about. Four bins for your socks and everything, nice and easy. And here is your laundry chute for your stinky socks at night. Bang. You don't have to keep those in the camper anymore. And this is nice too. You notice how much space you get into your pass-through while you open up your bed here? So if it's raining out and you got your awning open and you have your camp chairs right here and you don't feel like going outside to get all wet, you can have everything right here. Lift up your bed, grab your chairs, walk underneath the awning. You don't even have to get wet anymore. So that's nice. Two cutouts here in your cabinets for your storage for your clothes up here. And those cutouts are for your CPAP machine or a cell phone if you wanted to charge that at night too. Big window in your bedroom on the both sides. Plenty of space here. And you can put a TV up in that corner. So like I said, we are in the Wildwood 22 RBS, 26 feet 11 inches, 6,100 pounds. I'm Michael here at the Great Outdoors RV in Greeley, Colorado. Give me a call at 970-313-4337 and ask for Michael. I appreciate you guys watching. Like and subscribe to the video. We'll see you next time.